It is time to enjoy each other's company, share friendships, and watch our students' lights shine. Thank you for the opportunity to celebrate the Christmas season as a St. Rita family. Bless the students, teachers, staff, families, and friends. Especially bless those who are not able to be with us today and for those who are serving our country. Help us to remember the reason for this season, Jesus. So our hearts with special moments and times where we can be present, send peace, be kind, and make time for others. In your name, amen.
Are you feeling the Christmas spirit?
Yeah.
Maybe a little bit? Yeah? A little bit? A lot. Please welcome Brittany's class. They are going to perform a song, Christmas Time is Here.
get ready. That was a very good sign. Very good, Theodore. Alvin, you were a little flat. Watch it.
Thank you.
So we have have four seniors graduating this year. I would like them to come up. I have TJ. TJ, come on up. I've got Roberto. Keegan. And we have one other senior who's not here today, and that's Logan. So the gift that we give our seniors every year is a shirt. It's embroidered. It says the class of 2020 on one side and has their name on the other. So congratulations, guys. Merry Christmas.
In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken. The entire Roman world, and everyone went to their town to register. Maria?
I'm home, honey. How are things going? Maria!
Oh, I'm coming. Very slowly, but I'm coming.
Well, hello there. I was about to send out a search party.
Ha ha ha, very funny joke. Thank you.
Of course. So, were you able to get in touch with my parents in New York? Are they okay with us skipping Christmas with them this year?
Don't know. See how we can. It's Jen Nana's 95th birthday celebration, and we might not have her around for another one. Grandpa wants everyone to come home.
Okay. I don't see how we're going to do this in enough time. I have to stay at work Christmas Eve to make sure the computer software doesn't glitch. I don't have a choice. With you on a strict doctor's orders, how am I going to keep the computers running, do all the Christmas shopping, and get us to New York by Christmas morning?
God is good. I'm sure he will make a way. Anyway, I can do a lot of shopping. Right, here comes the couch.
Oh, Maria, be serious. I know.
No, this is really important.
You're right. God is good. I'll pray and he will make a way. Don't worry.
Thank you.
So, Joseph also went out from the town of Nazareth in Galilee, of Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. Maria, are you doing all right? We need a little, move a little quicker if we're going to make it to the last train to New York.
Okay, Joe. I'm right behind you.
Honey, it's time to go. The train.
I know, but look, Joe. It's Christmas. God gave his son for us. Surely we can give this woman and child a moment of our time.
Are you all right?
Yes. My daughter and I, we're trying to get to the next town to be with my husband, the father. He's in the hospital.
And we don't want him to be alone
for Christmas. But we're $20 short for bus tickets.
Joe, we can help them.
I only have $100 bill.
Perfect.
And that's all I brought.
Here you go. Merry Christmas, and may God bless you. Oh, thank you so much. You have no idea what this means to us. God bless you and Merry Christmas. Thank you, Joe.
Joe and Maria made their way to the train and arrived in New York. Maria had to make a stop at the train station bathroom while Joe was waiting for her outside. He was still worried about finishing everything in time, but he knew the Lord would make a way.
Silent night, holy night.
Man, oh man, we're gonna be late. I should have gone to the store instead of waiting until we got to New York. I'm not gonna have anything for the children's Christmas morning gift exchange. Hey, give me the coat.
What?
I said, give me your coat now.
Okay, okay.
You rich people think you own the world, walking around with your fancy clothes and all your money.
I don't want any trouble.
It's okay, honey. I'm just helping out a friend. He's a little cold, so I thought I'd give him a hand. Or, in this case, a coat.
Oh, what?
Oh, hey, there's a really nice pair of warm gloves in the pocket, too.
Gee, thanks, honey. Well, we had better get going. It was really good to see you. Yeah, whatever.
Bye, it was nice to meet you.
Wow, it's really chilly out here. We stay in here much longer, I'm gonna need the bathroom.
Well, come on, Joe, let's go.
Jealousy, glory to the Lord.
Maria and Jill had finally made it to town. They were both very tired from traveling, and Maria was not moving very quickly. Maria and Joe could not wait to get to their hotel room to rest.
Christensen?
Okay, let me check right here. There it is. It seems that we were expecting you here yesterday.
Now you look here. My wife made reservations online, and we have paper to prove it. Excuse me, do you happen to know if there's any rooms available here?
We would try to be everywhere in the city and all the rooms are full. If there's not room here, we're going to have to sleep in the car and we'll freeze to death.
Oh, don't worry. There's a power outage in some parts of the city, so that people didn't have power came to the hotel that still had power. And that's why they're full. But don't fear. There's a church right next door to this hotel. And they've set up cots in the church for people to sleep and stay warm until the power is restored. Oh, wonderful. You say the church is next door? Yes, you can't miss it. And it's a beautiful star in the steeple. Just follow the star, like the three wise men.
Oh, yes, it feels like it.
Well, thank you so much for your help. You are very welcome. We are heading over there, so we'll see you there.
Great, thanks again.
Thank you.
come tonight. And how can I ever thank you? Who would have thought that among all this craziness tonight, we would be blessed to have a nurse right here?
I sure didn't expect this present to come tonight. I don't know how I made it without you.
Well, I'm so happy that I was here to help. That is such a good plan. I was upset that I wasn't able to make my shift at the hospital tonight, but he knew that I was needed here. God is good.
God is good. This was a surprise, a wonderful surprise.
I better go feed him. He's getting a little fussy. Could you help me?
Oh, of course.
Father, I've been wanting to talk to you ever since we got here, but with all the excitement, I really haven't had time. You see, we ran into several unfortunate situations on the way here, and I was unable to go to the store to get a Christmas gift. We signed up for the children's gift exchange, and now you're going to be short one gift. Joe, how long have I known you? Oh, it must be going on 30 years now. You baptized me. Yes, it has. So believe me when I tell you that you are a good man. I have watched you grow over the years, and your faith in God has always been strong. We are human. We make mistakes. But your heart is good, and you strive to follow God's word. When you tell me that you are unable to get a gift, I know it's probably because you are doing something else that is just as pleasing to the Lord. Why, look, he gave you a wonderful gift tonight, a happy, healthy wife and a new baby boy. How should God not be pleased with you? Father, you are too kind. In fact, Maria and I did have an exciting time getting here. I just can't believe that I'm a dad. Come to think of it, I'm pretty tired. You mind if I go get some coffee? I'll be right back.
We had a little extra money after a kind man helped us at the train station, so we ran across the street and got a few things in case they were needed.
Oh my, how very kind of you. Thank you so much. Yes, the couple had a healthy baby boy.
So it was just a few things of diverse wives and balls.
Oh, that will be a great help. As you can guess, I don't keep too many of those things around here.
And I have a toy.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Power outages all over the city because of the storm. Pole. The last third pole is to come here. Who would have known we would see you again? And you're the one with the new baby.
Who indeed? Excuse me, Father? Yes, my son? How can I help you? Well, I did something really bad today, and I feel terrible. I was just so cold. I'm so very sorry for treating you the way I did. You know, I didn't really have a gun. It was just an old stick I found. I understand. Sometimes it's hard out there in the world. We all make mistakes. But God forgives. When we are truly sorry and want to make it right, God forgives. You know, God knew that we had sinned, all the world. He not only forgave us, he gave us the most precious of gifts, his Son, Jesus Christ, born and died so that we might live. This is the true meaning of Christmas. If he did that for us, how can we not forgive each other? I understand if you can't forgive me and you want to call the police. I won't be calling the police. All is forgiven. I heard that there was a baby born tonight, and I found this old blanket, so I scrounged up some change to wash and dry it. It's not much, but it might help keep the baby warm. That is very kind of you. You know, Father is right. God works all things to his good. Look at us. We met for a moment in time, and now we're all here, celebrating the birth of Christ.
And you're a new baby.
Father, I want to thank you for everything you've done for me and my family. You kept us safe and helped me stay calm so I could deliver my baby boy. I can't imagine giving him up the way you sacrificed your son for our sins. Everything has worked out, yes, but I can't stop feeling bad that I didn't get a gift for the children's Christmas gift collection. I know all things work to your good, so I will trust in you. Then the king will say to those on his right, "Come, you are blessed by my Father. Take your inheritance. The kingdom prepared for you since the creation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me something to eat. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you invited me in. I needed clothes, and you clothed me. I was sick, and you looked after me. I was in prison, and you came to visit me." Then the righteous will answer him, "Lord, when did I see you hungry and give you food?
or thirsty and give you something to drink? When did we see you a stranger and invite you in, or needing clothes and clothe you? When did we see you sick or in prison and go to you? The king will reply, truly, I tell you, whatever you did for one of these least of my brothers and sisters, you did for me. Well, this has been a wonderful evening. God is not disappointed. Perhaps we should all try and get some rest. Maria, I have set up my office for you, Joe, and the baby, so that you can have a little privacy. It's not a fancy suite, but it's warm and quiet.
Well, thank you, Father. You are too kind. Oh, wait. I almost forgot. This is our gift for the children's Christmas gift collection. With everything happening, I completely forgot it was in there.
Well, Joe? All things work together for his good. How did Maria and I get the gift? When did you buy this present? I thought...
That's a great question. How indeed. Merry Christmas, Father.
And a very Merry Christmas to you.